Good morning and welcome to the fifth Sunday of the month. January has gone through very quickly. Now, if you remember, in pre-COVID days, the fifth Sunday was our wildcard Sunday. Something a bit different. Well, as we continue to emerge from the pandemic, today will be a meeting of two halves. Part traditional, then an intermission, and then into the world of DreamWorks. So, on to our opening song. As we go forward, we're going to sing the song number 954, God's Soldier Marches As to War. Indeed, let's fill the world with music.
Thank you.
Shall we pray? Lord, we pray for strength so that we can be true to our calling, so that we can stand amidst the chaos of everyday life. May we go out into the dark places and shine your truth for all to see. Let us be courageous and sing out the gospel story. And we all said, Amen. Yes, indeed. Our next song links into a theme from the second half of today's meeting, miracles. I felt a new and loving touch upon my heart and soul. And thinking of the chorus which says, a miracle, yes, a miracle, God's Holy Spirit came and we are not the same. As the COVID restrictions have changed this week, we will review how we set up some of the things that we do. We won't rush in and suddenly put the chairs back in rows and stack us in, but we will just be led of how we all feel. As I have said before, we'll use common sensibility. The arrangements for the funeral service for Margaret Clark are well underway. The service at the Crem will be at 12 o'clock. And then afterwards, the service of Thanksgiving will be here at 1:30. And that's on Monday, the 7th of February. And the service at the hall will lead straight into the refreshments and a time of sharing with the family and each other. Can I ask you for prayers for a resident who had just moved from Howard House to the Priory, who passed away earlier this week? Adam came to the prayer meeting here last week, in fact, and was looking forward to coming this Sunday. We think of his family and we think of the residents and staff at this time. I would also like to thank you for those watching online who are sending in your offering. It is encouraging to see and very much welcome. Thank you. Now, on to a song before our meeting turns into a more musical theme. Why should life a weary journey seem? Jesus is my light and song. After this song, we'll have a musical interlude, which will be a good time for you to go and get yourself a cup of tea or coffee, maybe even a biscuit, and settle down to hear four cracking songs from DreamWorks Films.
Thank you.
quite a while ago, DreamWorks came up with two films, Joseph, King of Dreams and The Prince of Egypt, both Bible stories we know so well. Now, we had both of these as VCRs, if you can remember them. Chris and Louise were brought up on them, and as you know, still have a love of musicals and singing. Well, we start with Joseph and the simple song Bloom, a message that whatever gifts we have, we need to share. However, we need to share them with humility, as we are reminded that we all have a part to play in the rich colour of life. The flowers reaching for the sun are all uniquely blessed, but though each is special, not a one is better than the rest. This is the main lesson that Joseph had to learn. He thought he was better than his brothers, and God took some drastic action. At the end, though, he realized that being great wasn't about what he could do, but more about how he did it. He may have been Pharaoh's right-hand man, but in God's eyes, he was one of 12 brothers.
You've seen the damage words can do. When full of thoughtless pride, now heed the wiser voice in you that calls to be your guide. The flowers reaching for the sun are all uniquely blessed, but though each is special, not a one is better than the rest. Bloom, bloom, may you know the wisdom only time breeds. There's room, bloom, and you'll grow to follow where your heart leads. Bloom and may to give away.
Thanks, Mom.
We now move forward. Joseph is in jail, and he begins to realize that he is not in control of his life. Yes, he was sold into slavery by his evil brothers, but he had worked his way up and become a trusted slave and done well for himself. And then through no fault of his own, he found himself back at the bottom again, in a pit, in jail. Instead of sinking into despair, the realization that other forces are at work, and that means being humble again and handing his life over to God. And he sings, "You know better than I, you know the way, I've let go the need to know why, for you know better than I." Here is Chris with the song, "You Know Better Than I."
I thought I did what's right. Thought I had the answers. I thought I chose the surest road, but that road brought me here. So I put up a fight and told you how to help me. Now just when I have given up, the truth is coming clear.
For you know better.
not see the reason, but maybe knowing I don't know is part of getting through. I try to do what's best, and faith has made it easy to see the best thing I can do is put my trust in you. For you
Thank you, Chris, for both today and the recording that was made in the front room earlier this week. We are changing musicals now and moving forward in time. We go from a time when Joseph and his family were held in high esteem to the time of Moses, when that is definitely not the case. Prince of Egypt tells us about the calling of Moses to be the deliverer of God's people. We start with the song, "Look at your life through heaven's eyes." This reminds us that we do have to have faith and let God work his will as he knows the big picture. Whatever we try to build, whether they're things or ourselves, will not measure up in the eyes of God. And that for the best way for us to ensure that what we build is acceptable in the eyes of God, we need to try and look at it through heaven's eyes.
A single thread in a tapestry, though its color brightly shine, can never see its purpose in the pattern of the grand design. And the stone that sits on the very top of the mountain's mighty face doesn't think it's more important than the stones that form the base. So how can you see what your life is worth or where your value lies? You can never see it through the eyes of a man. You must look at your life. Look at your life through heaven's eyes.
No. No, I don't know how.
A lake of gold in the desert sand is less than a cool fresh spring. And to one lost sheep, a shepherd boy is greater than the richest king. If a man lose everything he owns, has he truly lost his worth? Or is it the beginning of a new and brighter birth? So how do you measure the worth of a man in wealth or strength or size? In how much he gained or how much he gave? The answer will come, the answer will come to him who tries to look at his life through heaven's eyes. And that's why we share all we have with you, though there's little to be found. When all you've got is nothing, there's a lot to go around. No life can escape being blown about by the winds of change and chance. And though you never know all the steps, you must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the dance. Ha! Come on!
Can't do that.
Oh, just follow me. We'll come naturally. Come, come, down here with me.
No, no,
come
please,
on,
come.
Watch
no,
close.
No, please, I.
Look here. Oh! Come on.
It's easy.
There you go. Come on, Walter. Let's go! What a man is worth by what he builds or buys. You can never see with your eyes on earth. Look through heaven's eyes. Look at your life.
Look at your life. Look at your life through heaven's eyes.
Hey!
Very powerful words brought to us from a stage show. If a man loses everything he owns, has he truly lost his worth? Or is it the beginning of a new and brighter birth? So how do you measure the worth of a man in wealth or strength or size? Is it how much he gained or how much he gave? The answer will come. The answer will come to him who tries to look at his life through heaven's eyes. May we all try to look at our own lives through those eyes. Moses went from being a prince at the top of the pile to a nobody, an exile from all he had known. He had certainly lost everything. Well, when you're at the bottom, there is only one way to go. And that took two things, the intervention of God and a miracle. The journey Moses had to go on was one of believing who he was and believing who God is. We're going to finish with the song, When You Believe. Moses grew in strength and stature as he learned to believe and trust God. This is something that both Joseph and Moses had in common and is still true for us today. There can be miracles when we believe. Now, these miracles may be great or small, but they will come if we have faith and believe. As we listen to this song, I invite you to join in and sing along. And if you're brave, you can try the Hebrew when it comes on the screen, or you can just read the translation. And at a certain point, if you are able, I will invite you to stand as well, and we will claim the words of the refrain for ourselves. There can be miracles when you believe. Though hope is frail, it's hard to kill. Who knows what miracles you can achieve when you believe? Somehow you will. Now, you will. You will when you believe. You will when you believe. You will when you believe. May we all believe in miracles and claim them today. Amen.